Now let's use this same concept to create other geometric primitives. I'll use this cube over here to create a cylinder. Okay. So if you remember from the last lesson, you find the center of a square or any rectangle, parallelogram, trapezoid, etc., by creating a line from the diagonals, and then you find the center, and then I'm lining my ruler up parallel to one of the edges and creating a center line. Same thing, I'm lining my ruler up parallel to the bottom edge, creating a center line. I'm going to erase away that back edge so that it's not interfering with what I'm doing right now. So I want you to visualize just how I created the center, finding the center of the square and the edges. And there's a very specific way to find a circle using geometry, but we're not going to do that. We're going to freehand it. So you want to make sure that the arcs of your circles are going to be circular. Okay, so I'm going to turn my paper around and just use my knowledge of what a circle looks like and just draw very light. Not only does using light pressure help your mobility, it's actually really hard to get the correct shape if you're pressing too hard. Okay. So there's my best freehand guess of a circle. Okay, so I'll do the same thing with the back plane. Now don't get confused because we're going to have a lot of lines there. So I'm finding the diagonals on the back plane. Locating the center points of the edges. And now I can draw my circle tangent to the edges of the back plane. So for the cylinder that we're creating, we have the front facing plane of the cylinder and we have the back plane of the cylinder. Finding the edges is super easy because you already know where the center of the front and back cube planes are. You can connect those dots and that creates the top, bottom, and sides of the cylinder. So I'm going to lightly lighten up those lines of the cube so that you can see the cylinder. So this is how you create a cylinder in perspective, right? Using a cube to help you find a circle, which would be what a cylinder, when you're looking at it right on, is a circle. And then the back circle plane in the shape of a circle is the same as the front plane, it's just smaller. See, I can use this as a unit of measure, compare, and it's a little bit smaller. Okay, so what's in back is going to be smaller, what's in front is going to be bigger. So let's create a cylinder using the next square, but we're going to go in a different direction. Now, again, we're looking at a square in perspective, but the same concept applies if you want to find the center. You create your diagonals. Here's your center. You use that center. I'm going to line my ruler up parallel with this edge and create my center line. This is the tricky part. You use the vanishing point and line it up with the center going this way to find the center on the vertical edges. So on the horizontal edges, you're using the object to find the center of the top and bottom edges. On the vertical lines, you're using the vanishing point and lining it up to find the center. And then you can create your ellipse in perspective. Okay, so you do the same thing over here. You create your diagonals. We're going to use to find the center of the top and bottom edges, right? And then the vertical edges, we're going to use the vanishing point And then you can draw your ellipse, which is a circle in perspective. Okay, and so then I'm going to connect the center of the top and the center of the bottom, and I'll erase away the cube guide a little bit. So now I've created a cylinder in a horizontal view. Let's turn this cube into a cone. Okay, so the same rules apply. We're going to find the center of the top. And this time we don't need to find the center of the edges because we know that a cone comes to a tip. And we're going to find the center of the bottom. Now a cone, the bottom of a cone is a circle. In perspective, it's going to be an ellipse. So we're going to find the center of this bottom plane by creating the diagonals. And this time we're going to use the vanishing point to find the center of the back and front edges. Okay. To find the side edges, we're going to use the center point. So now we know where our tangents for a circle are at, so we can draw the arc of our ellipse, which is a circle in perspective. And then we can connect the point to these outer edges, and look what you have. So now let's create a cone using this cube, and then we're going to defy gravity by having the cone not laying on its side. So we're going to find the center of the left panel, because that's going to be the top of our cone. And then we're going to do the same thing. We're going to draw our diagonals, find the center point of the vertical, use the vanishing point to find the center point of the back and front edges. And now we have our tangents for our ellipse, and we can draw our ellipse in there. Connect the edges to create the cone. So up here, we're going to create some spheres. Okay, so I'm going to use this one to create my first sphere. So I find the center point of each plane. This is the side plane, front plane. The back plane is really super thin because it's close to the viewer. And then the back plane. So now you have your tangents of your ellipse, axis of rotation. And now we'll do the same thing. So that is the cross-section of the sphere we're going to build. We're going to find the top, the center point in the top plane. We already have the center points in the side plane, and we're going to find the center point in the bottom plane. So now we have the tangents for our circle that's going to form the outer part of our sphere. So because you're looking at a sphere above the viewer, the arc of the outer contour is arcing up. This bottom arc is invisible. It's in the back. You can also draw the cross section because you have the points of the top, front, and back. You can also draw the cross section, the vertical cross section. The center of the cube, the center of the sphere is going to be where the axis of rotation of these two cross sections meet. So the viewer is looking at the bottom of the sphere, and this is the top of the sphere, and so the cross section contours are going to be arced up.